What's up? I'm Matt. Going to be running the panel today. And I think we have 0xKYC and A0 coming up. I think Adam's the 0xKYC. Yeah, come on up. And who is it? Is it Mike that's from A0?
Mic check.
Yeah, come on up. Do a little mic check. Make yourself at home. We're going to keep this thing fun and sweet and informal and engaging. So, welcome everyone. How does it feel to be back at ETH Warsaw, you two?
Man, it feels so great. I mean, last year was like the very first ETH Warsaw in general. But seeing what the team has pulled off for this year is like really awesome. And for us, it's like some kind of homecoming. We have really great like memories from last year's hackathon, but the overall conference. And it's great seeing also other teams like originating from this hackathon being here now on stage with us. So exciting.
What about you, Adam?
Yeah, we are super excited to be here. Kind of like a full circle of everything a year ago. Actually, we are still under a year because it's like the hackathon only started tomorrow last year. So I haven't even met Dylan by the time a year ago from now, my co-founder from the hackathon here with us and the rest of the team. Really cool stories on the way.
Yeah, so to give you guys some context, I'm Matt. I do the socials here for ETH Warsaw, do client work for a couple of other clients. And I didn't know who these guys were until around April, May, I think we all started talking. I started talking to Adam first and Dylan, and then about a month or two later, I found out about A0ID and I hopped on a call with Mike and your other guy. Remind me his name?
Dennis.
Dennis, and we kind of realized that we can do these success stories for projects that were born out of ETH Warsaw. This is like it was such a pleasant surprise because I had no idea that any of this stuff like happened. And now it's like, oh, you know, you guys have pre-seed round, you know, we'll get into all that stuff too. But I guess, you know, for everyone that's in here and anyone that's listening at home, it's like, you know, let these guys be your beacon of hope. Like you can really start and, you know, come into this conference building and not actually having any plan or any idea of what you're about to put together. And it can turn into a project that ends up being funded and comes back to partake in the conference literally a year later. So, kudos to you guys, kudos to your teams and your growth over the past year. And maybe, yeah, we'll pivot into, I guess, start us off, you know, from day zero, both of you. Like, how did you get to ETH Warsaw? What was your experience? What were the feelings like being here last year, being in a place where you had no idea what you were about to do, and then take us from there up until like the end of the hackathon, and then we can kind of dive into what you guys did afterwards.
Got it. So I'm from Warsaw, but I actually used to live in Berlin a year ago. So I had to come all the way, even though I'm from here. And I only came because I got the hackathon pass. I was like, okay, it's for free. I'm coming. So then when I arrived here, we started a group chat in Discord. And there was one more guy that I met at Antler in Berlin. So we were like, okay, we know each other. We're doing the hackathon team together. The next day, we already had more than five people actually come together. And actually, four of us still work together on this project. Me and Dylan ended up being the co-founders. Philip from Copernic Space was also our co-founder, but Copernic Space is doing great, so he's still there too, because that was, you know, startup life is very, very hectic. Like, our startup so far is default dead from the beginning by any metric, but we're somehow alive. So that's how it goes in this world. We're making progress in a way that we had an idea that's very futuristic that we actually already kind of achieved by creating private DeFi swaps where you mix funds very soon also on Curve with our protocol without running the risk of mixing them with sanctioned individuals. And the problem is that if we capture the whole market right now, we'll make probably around $300,000. which is not enough. Still more than we made so far, but it's hopeful. But we are pivoting to a different niche with the same tech that we built for uniqueness verification and deduplication of bots, which is something that came to us naturally from a different hackathon when we won the one user, one vote, partly thanks to MG, our team member who I met in Bali, who never lost a hackathon, so it was kind of certain that we're going to win. Yeah.
Nice. That's a super awesome story there. And what about you?
I mean, in our case, it was kind of similar. So in the beginning, I was like working with Dennis already, my now co-founder. And we were actually like traveling from like conference to conference to try things out to see what should be our next big thing. And we knew, so we are building on LF0. It's like a new layer one blockchain with privacy features, like super fast chain, super interesting to build on. And we were following their development for quite some time. And we were like, also, we had a friend from Warsaw, and he was like, guys, where's this like first time EVE conference in Warsaw, and you should really come because like the organizers are well connected, a lot of cool teams are coming, and also LF0. And we were like, hey, this should be this is a great opportunity to really try something in a cool setup with maybe meeting new people, trying out a team setup, and just starting something or like trying a new idea. And so we did it. And the interesting thing is like one core developer at the hackathon team, we just met him one day before the hackathon. So we were three people from Berlin, like me and Dennis and also another friend of us. And so we set up this team of four and we were like, hey, we can now really use this chance to create something, to test something we had in mind. And this is in our case, a domain system, something similar to ENS, which will be in the future the very first privacy-preserving domain system. But back then, during the hackathon, the simple idea was developing this kind of domain system with Rust smart contracts, because LF0 is, as some of you might know, not an EVM chain, but they're using Substrate, which is enabling Rust smart contracts. So this was also a challenge for us because we were coming from the EVM space from us. And then, yeah, we took this challenge. It turned out pretty good. And there was one interesting thing I might tell later in this panel, but we announced the project even before knowing that we will win the hackathon the next morning after we finished it. This was pretty, pretty interesting.
Yeah, that's right. I remember you saying that you guys hadn't really like, and that's the risk, you know, of doing what we're doing here. It's like you might show up not having any idea. They didn't even know what they were building yet, but they announced, you know, the project, and then the next day, didn't you say? Can remind us the number? Like you guys had a lot of followers that showed up.
Yeah, I think we got like 2K followers on Twitter like in a couple of hours after announcing it. So yeah, I think this was a kind of cool move.
Yeah, and so we'll get into kind of like how your guys' paths dissected and or diverged and kind of like, you know, which route 0xKYC went and which route A0 went. I think to kind of tie it back into what, you know, developers can do here is look, like they didn't know, you know, Mike and Dennis knew each other, but they didn't know like their third person. They only met each other very recently. I mean, it was like less than a day, you said. So same thing with Adam. They all met within the Discord. They weren't really like chatting to, you know, directly. They didn't even know each other in person. So I guess, you know, me being the panelist here, I want to encourage people that the devs, especially if you're new and you don't know what you're doing or, you know, just put yourself out there, talk, network, try to meet as many people as you can, jump into the Discord, ask help from mentors, and inevitably you'll find someone. We are also doing like a team meetup once the hackathon starts, like that'll kind of plug people in that don't necessarily have a team yet. So why don't we take it? So, you know, hackathon happened, you guys won, fill us in like what happened after the hackathon and then maybe like go forward 6 months and then we can kind of pause there and dissect a little bit. From 0xKYC's perspective, like what happened after the hackathon?
I just wanted to follow up. I mean, if you're lost and you're looking for a team, you might as well join us.
Nice.
Basically, I guess both of our hackathon projects got a little bit lucky. So with A0, obviously, they have the support of the main chain, Aleph0. With us, we have actually support of Outlier Ventures, that, who found us? It's not really often that a venture capital firm comes to you and asks you, can we invest?
Yeah, I think it's really cool. Sorry to cut you off. I think it's really awesome how you guys have this kind of, you got reached out to, or you got hit up by Outlier, and then they kind of gave you the stepping stones that you needed in order to be successful, you know, to kind of mirror what's been going on from the A0 side. You guys had your own little like incubator and like learning lessons that were kind of handed to you instead of, you know, being thrown into the fire, so to speak.
Our first angel investor also was one of the mentors. So it was kind of like it propelled us forward. And we do it the same way right now when we find investors who want to invest in us. And then we tell them, you want to invest, that's great, but let's hold on, we'll find more investors, so they join you, so you're not the first, but we value your vote of trust. That's what we did last time, that's how we closed our pre-seed round, and how it went forward is, essentially after Outlier Ventures, we were reincorporating in the US, and we didn't even have an EIN, that was like 4 or 5 months off. So by then, we didn't even have a bank account, but there was a demo day, so we already started raising the next round. Without a bank account.
Yeah, that's epic. Yeah, that's.
That's crypto.
Sorry?
That's crypto.
Yeah, that's crypto for you guys. So just like figure it out as you go. That's like the biggest theme here. What about you guys?
I mean, in our case, the interesting thing is that LF0 is like one of the like foundations or layer one blockchains, which is super supportive for ecosystem projects. So they just set up like an ecosystem funding program, which is some kind of holistic support program for ecosystem teams. This means that they are not only providing us in our case with monetary support, but they are also providing us with some kind of design support, business development, tech development, auditing services, stuff like that. So it's like really holistic. So if you're like a new team which is maybe building your very first big thing, this is some support you actually need to increase the possibility of actually succeeding, because so much or so many things can actually go wrong, and yeah, so many potential hiccups are on the way to become some kind of mature venture, which is also sustainable. And maybe one step back to right after the hackathon, right? So usually you have a team, maybe you have just met like a couple of days ago, and then during the hackathon, it's like some kind of group dynamic, everyone's contributing equally, right? But after the hackathon, you actually recognize, hey, some people might have like way more experience with others. Some might have maybe contemporary or different matching skill sets, but others might not. So afterwards, it's about finding the right setup to create a team which can push this into a venture. In our case, we really had great luck with our team. So all of them wanted to stick with us and keep building this project. Some had like full-time jobs already. Some were like freelancers working for different things. Me and Dennis, we were like, hey, we were looking for something full-time where we can push like the founder lifestyle. And then over the next couple of months working together, we realized what the best setup for the long term should be. So for example, the person who was like supporting us a lot but had a full-time job at Gitcoin at the same time, he was like, hey guys, it was an awesome time, but for now, for me, it's the right like decision to stick with Gitcoin, go full-time, so it wouldn't be fair for the team to try to keep handle two things, right? So in the end, it's really about open communication, that if you form this team and you really want something which is sustainable, expectations have to be communicated, and everyone has to be honest in terms of how you plan ahead for the future.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. Communication is key in this industry, as we all know, like, and expectations, I mean, that is massive too. Like, make sure you guys align before you do engagements, and also like check-ins are super important too. So I also love how you guys at A0 or ALF0 is one of the sponsors here. For anyone that doesn't know in the audience, like I think your guys' approach, your lane is so unique and awesome because you kind of have the support, like we were just mentioning, of the main chain that is kind of offering like a one-stop shop. So, I mean, that is a super sweet kind of, angle that you guys have there locked in. And Adam, also at 0xKYC, I know that you guys, you don't have someone like A0, but you have Outlier, and I believe you did something with Buffercorn at some point. ETH Denver also has a pitching slash venture arm part of the conference, so maybe you could kind of talk about that and how they've helped you and any support that they've brought to kind of like propel you forward.
Yeah, I mean, in our case, the marketing, obviously pushing it out the first time, either you do something viral like a giveaway campaign, or you have some support of some big players. In our case, we were super lucky and actually even low-key surprised when Onfido, one of the biggest international identity verification services, decided that we are the future and they're going forward with the Web3 section, betting on us, essentially, writing a PR about our success in the hackathon with Aragon. And with Buffercorn, obviously they invested in us so far. And most importantly, I think next year at ETH Denver, everyone will be able to verify themselves with 0xKYC to receive priority access to the conference and some other perks. So it's definitely a cool thing for activation, for their Discord, for implementation of our system within Mantle's ecosystem, interoperable social community layer that we're also working on. I won't disclose the name yet, but the big benefit of our solution is that it's infinitely reusable and interoperable, and we already think serendipitous things happening to us magically from like a higher power, where literally we ask our clients, did you implement us? And they're like, yes, where we think like the lead is called, but no, they already did it because it's so easy.
So just keep showing up. I think the theme is here, like here for both teams, 0xKYC. I didn't know that you guys are going to be implemented in Denver next year in such like an awesome capacity. I mean, I only see monthly user acquisition going up, and all the stats will just keep scaling from there on out. And then I'm sure after the conference, you'll get more opportunity from that as well. So that's super awesome. Congrats on that. And congrats to A0. Let me just do a time check. We got 10 minutes. I guess I'll start asking some kind of like closing questions. What are you guys planning on achieving at the conference this year? You guys are 1 year old, let's say, at this point, or just about to be. What are your teams focused on this year? Are you looking to expand after? How is? I'll stop there, and then we'll talk about like new hires and stuff like that afterwards.
So in our case, it's actually like getting the word out, right? Because we have just launched on the mainnet, on Valve Zero mainnet. So for all of you, you will be now able to like register your very first A0 ID. It's like a basic, so we start with a basic domain system similar to ENS, and all this fancy privacy stuff will be introduced at a later stage. And in our case, we prepared some kind of like free domain giveaway with like a super easy checkout process. So for all of you guys who don't have a Substrate wallet yet, right, you can just register with your email, and then you have this kind of complexity of onboarding to a new chain abstracted away. So really hit me up afterwards, I will give you some QR codes, and then you can feel and experience this like blockchain LF0 and also our domain service for the first time. So we really want to make sure that you guys have a smooth onboarding to the ecosystem, a great, good first experience. And yeah, so also like after this panel, just hit me up if you have more questions, like why we are building on LF0, why we are not on the EVM side of things right now. Yeah, that's it basically.
Cool, thanks Mike. And what about you, Adam?
In our case, we are hacking again because it's one of the rare occasions when we're all together physically. We're mostly working remotely. At some points, even Seba was in the middle of a jungle in Brazil. G in Korea, I was in Bali. Delan in Kołobrzeg, Alicia in Warsaw. Lindsay is now just survived a hurricane in Florida. So it's pretty hectic. But like now we're in person. We can work together on the core concepts of what it is to be 0xKYC-er, what it is to be creating Sunscreen, which is our anti-bot product for Discord. And we're also looking to hire somebody. We're looking for a product designer, backend engineer to join our team.
Cool, that's good to know. Let me get you a link. I have some links I can share where you can set up a job posting on crypto jobs list. So let's talk about that after the panel. So I'm A0 ID, Aleph Zero is a sponsor of the event. So you know, super great opportunity to meet them that way. You guys are also partaking in the, why don't you go ahead and say.
Yeah, so maybe one thing to add. So, I mean, we started at last year's hackathon, and this year we will be actually sponsoring the hackathon with small bounties. So for every one of you guys who think about, hey, maybe I will try something out on LF0, if you integrate our domain system, we have some cool small bounties for you. And this is like really easy to get. So if you have a working integration, and we have a cool resolver library. So this means it's just a couple of lines of code you can integrate, even only on the front end level if you want to do, and then you're good to go.
Super awesome. And yeah, 0xKYC is getting the in-person time that is invaluable. So it's super great that you guys are all together in one conference right now. And that's, I mean, you know, the ideology of conference hopping also comes into play here, where teams can get in-person time and really hammer out details that they can't do in remote settings. Those are kind of the, I guess, challenges with what we do in crypto. But we have like 5 minutes. Do you guys have, are you guys open to maybe taking questions from the audience? Is there anyone that has questions that's here right now? And I always say, don't all get up at once, you know? But yeah, sure, let me go over here. I'll give you the mic. So it catches in the recording.
Any plans to go multi-chain?
Yeah, I think that's a good one for both teams.
That's a great question. In our case, definitely. So, I mean, we are building currently on the Substrate technology, which LF0 is utilizing. And in our case, it makes so much sense to go for other Substrate chains as well. And interestingly, on Substrate, you have this kind of messaging protocol called XCM. And this enables us in the future to develop one single domain system which can be resolved and be utilized on all Substrate chains which are connected. This means even managing your domain, the metadata, trading it on a cross-chain marketplace on Substrate in the Substrate ecosystem. If we are going into the EVM space in the future, this will highly depend on some technical things such as bridging systems between both ecosystems. But someday in the future, we should definitely look into some kind of meta aggregators of domain systems so that at some point in time, you have just one identity and you can use it all around crypto and Web3. This should be the future. Yep.
Sweet, super awesome. What about you?
We are starting by going off-chain right now to target a bigger audience to eventually take them on-chain again with our seamless user experience. Our main goal is to become invisible to make the chain obsolete from users' perspective. Well, there was like account abstraction, but there's also like progress in terms of user experience. So obviously we want to offer a Web3 native solution for Web3 natives. We want to offer a solution to problems, which is bots and duplicate accounts, airdrop farmers. We say we're destroying the farming industry, except for yield farming.
That's hype. I think, you know, frictionless and seamless integration and kind of taking your claws and digging into Web2 and getting folks onboarded, that we all know that mass adoption is the ultimate game here. And I think, you know, not knowing that you're using crypto but you're using Web3 rather is the move. So that's a super awesome play, man. I'm glad to hear that. I also we haven't spoken about this at all, but I think you guys are co-hosting the closing party, right?
I think so, DJ Matt K.
What's the story behind that? Like, where is it at? Maybe we can plug that as we close out here.
So I used to be a DJ way back, like over 10 years ago, DJing like all over the world. I even had a private tour manager in Mongolia at some point.
Okay, that's cool.
And now we're co-hosting the ETH Warsaw closing party. So you'll be opening the set. There's Jerry M from Splot playing in the middle, and I'm closing the party.
I'm excited to DJ with you, buddy. This is going to be cool.
Let's go.
A little shameless plug there, but yeah, we're DJ friends, and we didn't even realize this beforehand. So yeah, if you guys are going to be sticking around for the entire conference, 0xKYC is co-hosting it, and I'll be opening the evening and setting the stage for these two lovely gentlemen to close us out. Any final thoughts, Mike?
maybe to add, like, also today we have a super cool opening party for vConference.
Hey, flex on.
And I also see the main organizer on the back, so it's like organized by LF0 and the whole ecosystem. So if you really want to meet the people building this really cool ecosystem, just come by. It's a super cool place with a lot of fun stuff to do. I think 7, 8, or even 9 like ecosystem projects will also showcase what we are building right now. And yeah, it's the official opening party, so you all should join us tonight.
Woo! No, we party harder. No, you party harder.
It will be awesome, but I think you will also join, right? So we'll party together and
have
a really good time.
We're all going, so I'm pumped. Thanks, everyone. Thanks for showing up, everyone in the crowd. This is an awesome opener. Appreciate you guys coming up here. Give them a round of applause, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.